In 1993, I was sentenced to death for my involvement in this crime. I was not the trigger man. I was 18 years old.
Kenny was very young and very immature when the crime occurred. You're a teenager, you've been in some minor trouble, but now you are responsible for someone's death. And that is emotional and heavy to deal with. People who have no conscience, doesn't bother them very much. That bothered Kenny. His actions that he would be responsible for taking someone's life is something I think that has weighed on him every day.
I acknowledge that I'm guilty. I acknowledge that I should be punished for me.
I ended up being the one sitting on death row and I didn't even shoot the victim.
A lot of people go into the prison system and don't fight for their own redemption. They are not sorry for what they did. A lot of people don't go in prison and stay rooted in faith, seek to help others. And they certainly don't go in prison and develop artistic skills in the way that Kenny Reams has, and in the way that he wants to pass that on to other children and be an example.
And the hard part now is trying to figure out what's the meaning of all of this.
Because you know what, along the way, through development and growth, I'm sorry.
He is wanting to prove himself, I say. Like, prove that, you know, I'm not this person that I was when I was 18. I'm not this kid anymore. I made some poor decisions, yes. And, you know, I've learned from them. And now I want to be an asset to society.
I will be honest with you. I've seen some people who have been released from prison who had not done nearly what I've seen that Kenny Reams has done. So that lets me know that he's developing his mind, which enables him to produce the artwork that he's producing, to write the poetry that he's writing. And I think that just as he has nurtured and developed his mind, he can encourage other young people to do the same.
Kenny, more than almost anyone I've ever met in my life, has taught me what you can do with time. And hasn't he done that? In all of his time being locked up in solitary confinement, his art shows, getting married.
I've worked with hundreds of incarcerated people who were formerly incarcerated, and what sets Kenneth apart is his motivation, his drive, his deep desire to educate.
First of all, I'm thankful to have been given the opportunity to have this platform to have my story told.
His work has been all over the world. Like, he's spoken at Princeton and Harvard and Columbia. Like, how have you already been on these campuses? I've never been on these campuses. So it's like, wow, like, you've done what?
Kenny is someone who's like a natural curator. What I mean is he brings people and ideas together in really thoughtful ways. I received, you know, thousands of works for the bookmarking time, and he's one of a few dozen artists whose work appear, you know, full page.
Sometimes we get so deep into the ideas that I just feel like I'm talking to another educator, and we just plan some of the material for lectures together. And then I remember, oh, this isn't my colleague who's doing this at an office. This is someone behind bars, who's been living behind bars for all of his adult life. It blows me away.
I was a little kid trying to find my way through and committed things wrong.
But today, I want to be able to change that kid that's 6 years old life, but I also want to be able to give people opportunities. things to grow, to break the cycle of where they come from, those things, man. You know?
I've been in criminal justice for 45 years. I have worked with hundreds and hundreds of men and women who have been in prison, been released, in jail, awaiting trial, on death row for appeals. I've never met anybody like Kenny.
If Kenny were released, he has friends and family and community, not just community in Arkansas, but all around the world. And the good that he could do compared to what he's been able to do while confined in prison, the sky is the limit.
Kenny has built a reservoir of capital. I'm not talking about financial capital. I'm talking about trust capital. Give this man a second chance.
And so, yeah, if he is released, we have his back. We have been there for him. We've been consistently involved in his life. And we've shown that he can count on us.
And I think Kenny, with what he's done with his time in prison, could have just sat there. He realized that there was room at the top for him. And so while he was there incarcerated, he didn't spend time wasting time.
Kenneth Reams can be trusted to be a productive member of society because he's already a productive member of society. He's already demonstrated what he will do if and when he's released.
All of us, including Kenny, have a chance to really impact the world in a meaningful, measurable way by supporting his freedom.
His dude has been paid. Just give him a shot in life. I mean, don't throw the towel in on him.
And he's so focused, so serious, so courageous, and so eager to work for something better for himself and for other people that he just forges ahead.
You can really rest your head at night and know that you're making a good, safe, conscious decision in recommending that Kenny Reams be released. 45 years, hundreds and hundreds of people, and he is one in a million and really deserves a chance.
I'm a dreamer, I'm a go-getter, I'm hopeful. And I say to society,
the deal,
give me an opportunity.